That's the answer. Perfect. Perfect. So we are done with this question also. Can we go to the next question now? Everyone take question number 4. Just read through this question and understand this question. After which we will do it together. Shall we write down the basic data now? Working note number 1, basic data. Friends, once you understand the question, answer becomes very, very easy. Okay. ABC has exported goods worth $5 lakh. Okay. So it will be dollar receivable. How much is a dollar receivable? Is it turning out to be $5 lakh? Point number B, receivable in how many months? 6 months. So the duration will turn out to be how many months? 6 months will be the duration. The exporter wants to hedge the receipt in the forward market. The following information is available. The spot rate is given as how much? $2.5 per sterling. Alright, what is the interest rate they have given in UK? Is that turning out to be 12% is for 1 year, but our duration is only 6 months. So it will turn out to be how much percentage? 6%. Alright. And what about the US or the Canada? CAD interest rate for 6 months will turn out to be how much? It will be 7.50%. The forward rates will truly reflect the interest rate differential. It means the IRPT theory holds good. I'll write down like that. IRPT theory holds good in this case. Can you write down till here in your books now? Alright friends, everybody is clear with the basic data. I'll give you 2 minutes time. Just scribble and try solving it on your own. Alright friends, I believe you have all put up till here in your books. I'll now go to working note number 2. Working note number 2, analysis. Now listen, have they given the spot rate, they have given the UK interest rate, the CAD interest rate. From this, can I find out the 6 months forward rate? I'll write down 6 months forward rate. I can find this out now. 1 plus RH divided by 1 plus RF is equal to forward divided by spot. So here the exchange rate being dollar bar sterling, the RH will be CAD. Okay, that will be 7.5. It will be 1 plus 7.5% divided by 1 plus 6% is equal to forward divided by how much? 2.5. So once I do this, let us check what is the answer I get over there. Do we get the answer as $2.5353 sterling? Can you write down this in your books now? Alright friends, have you all put up till here in your books now? Okay, so we have written down the basic data. We have got one part. Let me check if everything is comfortable. All comfortable friends? Okay. Perfect. Let's continue now. So we have got one thing. Now they are asking, find out the gain or loss to the exporter. If the dollar spot rate falls by 2% or the dollar gains by 4%. Okay, so I'll just write down the next working note. Impact if dollar falls by how much percentage, friends? It falls by 2%. If the dollar falls by 2%. Friends, what is the spot rate right now? Spot rate right now is turning out to be how much? 1 minute. Is it turning out to be 2.50 dollar bar sterling? What is the commodity over here, friends? The commodity is sterling. If they say dollar is falling by 2%, we can do that in two methods. Okay, I'll show you both the methods now so that you understand the overall logic also. Method one, we can make the dollar as a commodity. Okay, I'll write down, since dollar is falling by 2%, we can make dollar as a commodity. So how do you make dollar as a commodity? Can you tell me? I will do 1 divided by 2.5. I'll get the answer as 0.40 sterling bar dollar. Okay. Therefore, revised rate would be 0.40 minus 2%. It is falling by how much percentage? 2%. Minus 2%. I will get the answer as 0.392 sterling bar dollar. If I want, I can reconvert it now. 1 divided by 0.392. That will give me the answer as what? That will give me the answer as 2.55 dollar bar sterling. This is one way of doing it. I'll give you some time now. I will slow down. Write down this in your books. See, the dollar is falling by 2%. Sterling is not falling by 2%. If sterling was falling by 2%, what will you do? I will do 2.5 divided by 2% flat. Because we always focus on the commodity. I'll give you a minute, write down, understand. I will repeat this part once again after that. Thank you. Friends, have you all put up till here in your books now? Okay, I will repeat once again. The dollar is falling by 2%. If it was sterling falling by 2%, I would have directly done 2.5 minus 2%. But here, since dollar is falling by 2%, I have to make dollar as a commodity. Understood? And then I can solve this equation. I will be getting this answer. Or option 2, if you are a person who has attended my class, the way I solve the rate of appreciation depreciation is that I always keep saying that appreciation would mean plus and depreciation would mean what? Minus. Here, what they are saying is that this thing is falling down. What is falling down? Dollar is going to fall by how much percentage? 2%. So if dollar is falling by 2%, can I not say that it will be a value will be going up a little further? So the formula over here would be 2.5 minus something, some particular rate, okay, that is a going up rate, divided by this should give me the answer as what? Minus 2%. Alright, this is another way of doing it. So that would be 2.5 minus x is equal to minus 0.02x. Okay, so if I take the x on the other side, I can say 2.50 is equal to 0.98x. Therefore, x is equal to 2.5 divided by 0.98. I'll get the same answer as 2.55. Okay. So you can just start with this. Since dollar is depreciating, okay, I can say sterling is appreciating. Okay. So the new rate will be more than 2.5. I'll give you a minute's time, friends. Please go through this, and if you have any doubts, please let me know. Alright friends, have you all put up till here in your books? Both the ways you get the same answer. Method 1 is a more easier method, but I just gave it in all the ways so you understand what we are doing. Okay. Now I will write down inside this Roman number 2, gain or loss. Okay. Now listen. What they are actually saying is that the forward rate truly reflects the differential. So what is the forward rate we already got over here? Have we got the answer as 2.5353? Okay. So I'll write down amount received if forward contract is entered into. Okay. So suppose I enter into a forward contract, it will be $5 lakh divided by 2.5353. It will be 5 lakh divided by 2.5353, correct? And the next one, I'll find out amount received if forward contract is not entered. If I don't enter, I would be getting how much? I'll be getting 5 lakh divided by 2.55. So let us find out how much is 5 lakh divided by 2.5353. 197215. 215 what? It will be sterling, is it? Yes, dollar bar sterling. That is the exchange rate, right? It will be sterling. You get the answer as 197, okay? But if you don't do it, you get that 196078 only. So luckily you entered into a forward contract gain by entering into the forward contract is turning out to be the difference of this, that is 1161 sterling. Can you write down this in your books, friends? 197. It's 1137 that we have got. Little bit rounding off is there, don't bother about that. Alright friends, are you all clear with the first part? Okay, someone, you want me to explain the RH and the RF? I'll explain that to you. Look, RH and RF would be, this is the interest rate of home country. And this one is interest rate of foreign country. But remembering it like this is very confusing because in this question, it is dollar bar sterling. How do you know which is home country, which is foreign country? So we always focus on the exchange rate. Okay. Whatever is the numerator will be RH. Whatever is the denominator will be RF. So keep this one rule in your mind. Numerator of the exchange rate is the RH. Denominator of the exchange rate will be RF. Can you write down this in your books, friends? Alright friends, everybody is clear with this part. Can I go to the next one now? Okay. I hope someone you are clear with the logic of RH and RF. Alright. Now we'll go to the second part of the question. Dollar gains 4%. So I'll write down the next working note heading. Impact of dollar gaining how much percentage? 4%. Alright. Now friends, you know how to do it. So I'll write down revised exchange rate. Okay. Now listen. I'll put inside this pot. Dollar per sterling is how much? Is it 2.5? So what I will do is I will make it spot sterling by dollar first. So that will turn out to be 0.40 sterling bar dollar. Okay, point number 3, revised sterling bar dollar would turn out to be this plus 4%, right? So it will become 0.416 sterling bar dollar. Sterling bar dollar, and once you get this, I can actually find out the revised dollar bar sterling. That will be 1 divided by 0.416, that will be 2.40 dollar bar sterling. Can you write down this in your books now? Alright friends, everybody is clear with this part. So once I get the revised exchange rate as 2.4, point number B I can write down, okay, amount received if forward contract is entered. So here, what is the amount that I will receive? I think that amount will not change. 5 lakh divided by 2.5353 would be 197,215. Next point would be amount received if no forward contract is entered. Okay. Now that would turn out to be how much? It will be 5 lakh divided by 5 lakh divided by 2.40. That would turn out to be 2,8,333. So they would have got more. So loss by entering into a forward contract. Loss by entering into a forward contract would be 11,118. Okay, can you write down this in your books now? Sterling. All these are in sterling. All right, friends. Have you all put up till here in your books now? Fine. Let's go and read the final part now. This question was a little tough, so I became a bit slow. Next question, if it's easier, I'll go faster. Okay. Remains not changed over a 6 month period. So last working note. Gain or loss if there is no change over a 6 months period. Okay. Point number A, total amount under forward. What is the total amount under forward? 197,215 sterling. Point number B, total amount unhedged. If I don't go for hedging, how much will I get? I will be getting 5 lakh divided by what was the starting rate? 2.5, right? So there won't be any change, means it will remain at 2.5. I'll get the answer as 2 lakh sterling. So in this case also I'm making a loss, am I right? What is the loss I'm making over here? I'm making a loss of 2785 sterling. Can you write down this and finish it off? Alright friends, everybody is clear with this, so we are done with this chapter also, this question also. Can I go to the next one now? All clear friends?